Welcome back, everyone, to another Daikon Dissectional production hosted by Deathstroke 9. Today, we're going to be reacting to Tool Flood off the Undertow album.
Welcome back, everyone. This is Deathstroke 9, and today we're going to be looking at a new Tool song called Flood. And I'm not entirely sure if we've done any songs off Undertow yet, so now we are. I'm pretty sure I have never heard this song before, so there's that. Very exciting. Yeah, this was recommended by one of you guys. Thank you very much for recommending this. If you're new to this channel, please subscribe, because what makes my channel a little bit different than a lot of other reaction channels is that I like to really dissect the words and the music and figure out what they mean, at least in relation to myself. Obviously, music is subjective, and everyone might have a different interpretation. This is me, right? So I've got Flood here, right? And I've also pulled up the lyrics. So if you go over here, we've got the lyrics, all right? Haven't read them yet. I'm going to try to look at them while we're doing it, because there was no lyric video for this. So yeah, that's about it. If you like the video, like the video. Haha, okay. Yeah, so not entirely sure what to expect. Obviously, it's Tool, but I know that Undertow, it's a little bit more heavy than our more recent Lateralis and Fear Inoculum reactions that we've been doing. So let's see what we've got here. 3, 2, 1. Oh, pick scrape, nice. I can't tell if that's a delay pedal, or if that's literally like him hitting the note twice, or if it's two bass. Two basses? Rising, like we're going up, rushing through everything, breaking stuff, crashing against stuff. Whispering. A lot of whispering in the ears right now. Oh, boy. I need to pause it. I'm already letting it go on too long without pausing it. Man, okay. So first of all, this is very discordant. Dun, 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 dun. You know, it's very, like, like there's a few parts that sound, there's no cohesion here. It's chaos, right? And I think if the song is about a literal flood or a metaphorical flood, and they're trying to kind of portray that with the music, they're doing a very good job. I'm definitely hearing like something bad is happening right now. Now I'm hearing a lot of whispering going on in the background. There have been no lyrics so far. Which a lot of times help me kind of formulate my opinion on what it all means. But yeah, let's just keep going, guys. Very interesting song so far. I'm gonna bring it back a little bit. Is it entirely like, I mean, I know there are lyrics, but is it mostly an instrumental track? Anyway, let's keep going. There's something going on in here. There he is. I'd like to say water. The drums are really good on this. Here comes the water, he says. He's saying it a lot of times. Here comes the water. Oh, those drums are so good. Like it's filling up a hole. Whoa, what is that bass? Let's put a beat on it. Oh, yes. Heck yes. I'm gonna have to pause it again. Oh, okay, it's getting really good. Alright, I'm gonna bring it back. Alright, so it was complete discord this entire time. And now suddenly they like put it some type of bass line in the background that's bringing everything that's been happening the whole time kind of together. Cause you know, dun da da da. They just sped that up, and now it sounds like da 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 da. Right? It definitely makes me think of, oh, there's a flood coming in. It's water. It's filling everything up. He says, "Here comes the water" multiple times. Now he's gonna start. He starts singing. Can you hear? I mean, I don't know. It's interesting how young he sounds, or like his voice sounds. I don't know, a little bit higher maybe. I don't know, it definitely sounds different than it does on, like, I don't know, Lateralis. Let's just keep listening to it. This is really interesting. Let's keep going. 3, 2, 1, hit me. See that bass line? Wow. All I knew. All I believe. Crumbling images. No longer comfort me. Scramble to the world. Reach higher ground. Order insanity. Something to comfort me. Take what is mine. Oh, what is mine. Stop the king. What is mine. Bury what's mine. Soon the water will come. And claim what is mine. I must leave it behind. Oh, wow. Wow. Okay. I think I get it. Oh, his voice is so cool.
I was wrong. This changes everything.
Oh, that was so cool.
Wow.
I gotta pause it. I'm gonna bring it back. I wanna hear that again. I wanna hear the thought of, yeah, those, okay. I also need to go over the lyrics. So here's what I've got so far. Here comes the water, here comes the water, here comes the water. All I knew and all I believed. Everything that he held true. Crumbling images, okay? They're falling apart. They no longer comfort me. I'm scrambling to reach higher ground, to reach order and sanity, something to comfort me. So I take what is mine, hold what is mine, okay? Take and hold it, right? It's mine, 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 I have it. Suffocating it. I'm holding so tightly, I'm almost suffocating it. And burying it, I want to keep it. But the water is coming and is claiming what is mine, and now I need to leave it behind and climb somewhere up higher. Need to go to a new place now. The ground is not the rock I thought it to be. I thought I was high. I thought I was free. I thought I was there. Divine destiny. I was wrong. This changes everything. What could this be? And I think that this kind of it would be something different for every single person, right? There are multiple moments in my life where I've felt something like this, where you held on to something and you held it to be true. You thought it was something true and it comforted you and gave some form of order and sanity. And then come to find out you were wrong. And as you said, this changes everything, right? I definitely think that this could be applied to a million different things. Perhaps what Maynard is specifically talking about is, yeah, I don't know. I know that he was brought up in a church, so maybe it might have to do with that, although that would be pretty sad, because I am a Christian, right? So, yeah. Obviously, he built a house on the sand. Never mind. So my point is, I think that it's definitely about this kind of revelation, which kind of shows you, and it's like a cycle, right? And that's why it's a flood. It keeps rising. You keep needing to let go of what you had behind and move higher. But at the same time, so this song is kind of negative, right? It's taking it in a very, very negative light. But at the same time, I feel like, so he's going even higher than he was before. So while it is tearing him apart from these materialistic things, thoughts, and ideas, he's still ascending, right? He's still going up. So while it is negative what's happening, the end result might actually be positive. At least that's kind of what I'm getting out of it. I want to bring it back. Let's finish the song. That was so cool, by the way. Nope, we're not going here. 3, 2, 1. I don't know where we are. Oh, running away. Sorry, bringing it back even farther.
Wrong. This changes everything.
So cool. That's a moment of like realization. Everything's like stops, and it's like, oh dang. What now? Turn that up. High as it'll go. Water's rising up on me. truth has come to punish me. Just shout die? That's not in here, but I think that's what he just said. Wow. Oh, come on, why? Okay. Wow! How have I never heard this song before? Wow, wait a minute. Okay, I'm gonna bring that back up. There was something I wanted to mention. Wow. That ending was so cool. Okay. Let's look at these lyrics, right? What he says right at the end. Water's rising up on me. The water is rising up on me. I thought the sun would come deliver me. Okay. Sun, right? Think about that. It's water, okay? Water's rising up. He thought the sun, okay? What is the sun? Sun is a sense of warmth, comfort, right? The sun in the sky. It also evaporates water, right? Or it can dry up things. So he thought the sun would come deliver him. Whatever that comforting thing that he held as a truth was, but it was false, and the truth has come to punish him instead. The grounds break right under me. Cleanse and purge me in the water. That's how it ends. Is he... Oh, he doesn't go... Okay. That's why it's so negative. He doesn't keep going. He eventually... The ground just breaks underneath him. And he falls into the water. But the water itself is the truth. So he's running away from it the whole time. But then the water kind of cleanses and purges, right? So what is the purging is, you know, expelling the bad out of you, right? You get the purge. You're purging yourself of whatever it might be. Wow, this song's freaking deep. Like the water. Wow. Okay, then. It got really good. So the beginning was like an instrumental, almost like one of their like in between intermission things, right? Like I don't know if maybe that's the version I found was like two things put together, or if that's the actual full song. Let me know in the comments. Probably is the full song, because I feel like the music definitely went with even that beginning opening thing of just the stuff sounding like it's rising. Definitely felt like it went with what's going on. But anyway, thank you guys for joining me for this. If you're new to the channel, subscribe if you enjoyed, you know, my dissection of it. And yeah, leave a comment. Let me know what else you'd like me to react to or what you think the song is about. And I will see you guys soon. Deathstroke 9 out.